Hello, hello, it's Zasia here. Welcome to my Mixed Media channel. And today I have for you a guest designer project I prepared for Art & Soul Studio. So this is definitely gonna be a layout. And I'm starting with preparing the page from AB Studio. The page is called Amazing Life. And I'm gonna add a layer of clear gesso from Finavar. And this is an amazing mood board from Art & Soul Studio. I love the colors, beautiful. And I'm gonna be adding some stenciling with a texture paste black sand. And the stencil you've seen there, this is a stencil from Prima. I have to tell you, it took me a lot of time and a lot of effort to put the paste through the stencil, because the stencil is very intricate and the paste is very heavy body paste. But when I removed it, voila, that's the effect. So it's really, really beautiful. I did not actually expect that it's gonna be that nice. I was thinking it's gonna be one big mess, but it's not. And guys, I'm gonna be using a fantasy dice. There is few of them, different ones. And then some of the other dice I have at home. So not all of them are fantasy dice. And I'm gonna be spraying them with Lindy's Gang sprays. So there is three of them: Grease Lightning Green, Time Travel Teal, and Green with Envy Green. And here I'm repeating again with Time Travel Teal. And I will leave it on the side to dry. And in the meanwhile, I'm gonna add some stamping. That's the beautiful stamp from Rubber Dance, With Love. And I'm gonna be adding stamping with my favorite, the best ever, Jet Black Archival Ink. This is the piece I torn from the same Amazing Life paper by AB Studio, and I actually embossed it with Creative Expression embossing folder. The folder is called Bark, so it's not very maybe visible on the movie, but it has very nice texture, this tiny piece of paper. And I add some fluffy ink underneath, no idea how that's called. And I'm gonna be now adding everything with the glue I'm using. Actually, for the heaviest objects, I'm using a 3D matte gel from Finavar. You can of course use also a 3D glossy gel if you prefer, or you can even use a tacky glue. It will probably work fine as well, especially for this piece, which is just a piece of actually cardboard. Tacky glue may not work very well with the metallic embellishments. And here I am adding pieces of bark, actually of the tree bark, and again gluing it with a 3D matte gel. And I know for now it does not look like anything, but the challenge for this month, or the inspiration for this month, is it was to use also a texture. So that's what I tried to do. And because the mood board is so connected with the forest, so I added also, apart from bark, I added also tiny pieces of moss. There are two different kinds of moss. One is the one I actually found in the forest, and one is the one you actually can buy in the shops. And then a few branches, few small branches, and that is gonna be my photo. I'm protecting it with some piece of foil, and I'm using die cuts from AB Studio. So I used them, I cut them all by myself. And I'm gonna be using few different chipboards from Snipart also. And now you just see me placing everything together on the page. And it actually took me a long time, because it takes me always a long time to find the good place for the things. And even if you do that and you are not happy at the beginning, because obviously here I was not happy at all with what I was doing, at the end I'm actually, this is one of my best layouts ever, I really love. And so you just have to persist, you just have to add things, add layers. And my way to do it is to, die cuts from Fantasy, I actually place them straight away with the glue, but the rest of the elements I placed on the page, onto the layout. And when I was happy with the whole layout, then I took piece by piece every element and I glue it to the page. So that's the way I'm working, or that's the way how I'm working. And it proved actually very useful and very good. So now you see me, I'm putting either the chipboard or the paper elements. I'm gonna be also adding some mid-form castings, of course. And I just leave you quietly with the music and I'll see you in a second. So I'm back with some creative embellishments chipboards. I think they are actually MDF. They are beautiful. I embossed them also off the camera with those two embossing powders from Lindy's. I embossed first with one, and then when the embossing powder was still warm, I actually sprinkled the other color a little bit on the top, so it looks really nice. This is my technique for embossing stuff, and I really love it. And I decided to add some dry flowers. This is actually a poppy, tiny poppy, you know, the wheat kind of poppy you can find in the fields. And I am a big fan of poppies. And look, guys, how beautiful that looks on the page also. So there is always some place for splatter on my layouts or on my creations in general. This time I've done it with metallic paint from Finavar, and I love this snowflake chalk acrylics from Paper Artsy. Beautiful color which is actually very visible, and few stickers from 7 Dot Studio, and that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Have a look at the Art and Soul Studio for all the inspiration and for the projects which we are sharing there. As always, thank you so much for watching, for sharing this video with your friends, and for subscribing. And have a crafty day. Bye!